loneliness in youth is a super relevant topic. And because there's not so much known about it yet, I also have the opportunity to really do, well, new stuff. Everything I come up with is basically something that no one has looked at yet. That makes it very exciting for me as a researcher to look into this. So social relationships are crucial for human beings. It has consequences for mental health, but also for physical health. And about 50% of youth report that they are lonely. And what's even more devastating is that for about 3% of them, this is chronic. So it's really important to find out what's the difference between these groups of people who stay lonely and who are just temporarily lonely. How can we explain what happens when someone is lonely, and how can we prevent loneliness from becoming chronic? So what my research so far has shown is that there's not a single cause for loneliness in youth. There are different types of lonely people, basically. And that also means that there's not a one-size-fits-all solution for loneliness. So for interventions, we really need to look into what is the main reason for this person for being lonely. And what I'm going to do now is look more at concrete things that people might do in their daily lives to change their feelings of loneliness in terms of who they have contact with, how often they have contact, or how they evaluate that contact. Because loneliness is such a big problem and we currently don't really have solutions for youth, I find it very important to already see, based on what we've learned so far, how can we make a difference for lonely youth. So I give public lectures, I give advice to governments and to volunteer organizations, and really try to make a difference now.